It's time for Whey Protein 101. We're about to dive into the difference between whey concentrate, isolate, and hydrolysate. You'll see how each one is made, how they work in your body, what each one is good for, and of course, the pros and cons of these different proteins. My name is Shawn Walker. Let's dive in and let's get better. As you may know, whey protein comes from milk. Milk has curds and it has whey. Whey is the liquid remaining after milk has been curdled and strained. It's a byproduct of the way they manufacture cheese or casein. Whey protein is created by separating those components from the whey, and the major difference between whey concentrate, whey isolate, and whey hydrolysate is the whey and how much they're filtered, so how much of the impurities are filtered out. First, let's take a look at whey concentrate. Whey concentrate is the least filtered of all three proteins, which means it contains more fats, more carbohydrates, and more lactose as compared to isolate or hydrolysate. This limited filtration process gives you both benefits and, of course, there's some drawbacks. The first benefit is whey concentrate is typically the least expensive of all the protein types. If you're on a budget, that's a good thing, right? Now, moving on to the second benefit, because whey concentrate is filtered less, it still contains things like lactoferrin, which can help fight off infections and support your immune system. So there's some immune boost in whey concentrate. Also, because whey concentrate still contains some of the fats and carbohydrates, it's digested and absorbed into the body a little slower than whey isolate or whey hydrolyzed. Whey concentrate takes roughly 2 to 3 hours for the body to digest. So depending on your fitness and nutrition goals, this can be either a good thing or it can be a bad thing. Now, let's dive into the negatives of whey concentrate. Whey concentrate contains lactose, which you likely know can lead to bloating, gas, and upset stomach. So if you're at all lactose intolerant, you may find yourself clearing out a room or sprinting towards a toilet if you drink it. Let's just say whey concentrate will probably not be your best friend. Now, here's a little known shocking statistic which leads to a major downfall in whey concentrate. Whey concentrate can range anywhere between 35% and 80% protein by weight. This is one of the reasons why whey concentrate is less expensive. So if you're taking 10 gram scoop, it can be as little as 3.5 grams of protein. The rest can be fats, carbohydrates, and fillers. Or your scoop of protein may actually only contain 8 grams of protein. And unfortunately, most whey concentrates don't specify how much protein they actually contain, so you're left guessing. This large variance is actually in protein by weight leads to a whole bunch of problems, right? So if you need 15 grams of protein per day, you don't know if your protein contains 35%, 50%, or 80% protein. You don't really know if you're getting those 15 grams or if your body's actually getting the right amount. And because of the possible low concentration of protein, you may actually be paying more for your protein that you do actually get. So if you're not careful on what brand of protein you choose, you could be getting a small amount of protein and a whole lot of filler. So not the greatest thing. All right, let's move on to whey protein isolate. Whey isolate is filtered more, so it removes more of the impurities. Because of the filtration process used to separate whey isolate, it can be virtually lactose-free, carbohydrate-free, fat-free, and cholesterol-free. So there's some positives there. Now, if you're trying to cut on carbs and fats, or you need a pure protein to help muscle growth and recovery, whey isolate is a great source of protein. And if you suffer from any type of lactose intolerance, this will probably be the best source of whey protein because it contains little to no lactose at all. Also, because of the way whey isolate is filtered, it contains the highest amount of protein, which that's typically more than 90% by weight. So that's awesome. It has a higher percentage of protein than any other protein powder. So since whey isolate has most of the impurities filtered out, the body can digest it in as little as 30 to 60 minutes. So again, depending on your goals, the rapid digestion and absorption can be a good thing or it can be a bad thing. If you're trying to use whey isolate as a meal replacement, giving that, you know, satiation feeling or feeling full, probably not your best choice. But if you're looking for a protein source that can help you recover, you know, muscle growth, many of our CellSoft athletes actually use it for that. They love whey isolate because of the fast recovery. Now, there is one minor drawback to whey isolate. Because of the filtration process, some of the immune-boosting supporting nutrients like lactoferrin are filtered out. But for us, it's a small minor issue because we're drinking the protein for the protein and not for immune support. Now, the last type of whey protein is hydrolysate, or protein hydrolyzed. This is the most expensive because it goes through the most advanced filtration process. The filtration process breaks the protein down into its individual peptides. I think there are more cons to this type of protein than pros, but let's have a look and then you can decide. So the original point to the strict filtration process to remove anything you may be allergic to, but that also meant eliminating the infection fighting and immune boosting nutrients like lactoferrin. Because hydrolyzed protein is broken down into its individual peptides, it's also absorbed the fastest. Supposedly, it only takes 1 to 30 minutes to digest and absorb into your body. But is that a critical benefit? I don't really think so, but that's for you to decide. One of the downfalls of this type of protein is the taste, because when you break down the amino acids away from their protein chain and into their individual components, they taste terrible. A manufacturer may be able to get it to taste better, but that means they're adding impurities back into the protein and it kind of defeats the point, right, and the purpose. So is protein hydrolysate worth the extra money? I don't really think so. For our cell sauce pro athletes and their trainers, Whey Isolate is their go-to protein source. Before you go out and buy a protein powder, there is one more thing that you must know, because many people have a hard time digesting large amounts of protein in a short period of time. This is super obvious to some people because they drink 25 grams of protein and they get gas, bloating, and upset stomach. For others, it kind of goes unnoticed, but it can still happen. Because the problem is, if your body can't digest the protein, it just gets excreted, right, down the toilet. Your body never uses it, your muscles never use it, you don't get recovery. Worse, you've wasted your money buying and drinking protein you thought was doing something when in reality, it wound up in the toilet. In fact, studies actually show you can lose up to 75 to 80% of the amino acids during digestion. So to solve this issue for our cell sauce athletes, we created 100% Whey Awesome Sauce. Whey Awesome Sauce is a pure whey protein isolate that includes a special digestive enzyme blend. The blend is specifically designed to digest better and be absorbed by the body easier. So that means your body absorbs more protein and more amino acids, which means you get more muscle growth, faster muscle recovery, and should feel less post-workout and activity soreness. And of course, if you're absorbing more protein and more amino acids, you're saving some money. And this is exactly why our pro athletes and their trainers demand to use 100% Whey Awesome Sauce. You know, they need a pure protein source that can digest quickly and easily without causing stomach issues. So if you want something similar, or let's say you want the exact same thing, you want a quick digesting protein that doesn't cause stomach issues, and you want something that's been trusted, proven by professional athletes and their trainers, you should check out Cell Sauce's 100% Whey Awesome Sauce. Just head over to cellsauce.com/whey. And of course, we like to think it tastes great, but again, that's for you to decide. You know, Ty Masterpool, pro motocross racer, says Whey Awesome Sauce with just almond milk is so freaking good. And Tony Iacone, pro wakeboarder, says love the flavor, so good. Whey Awesome Sauce doesn't feel as heavy as other proteins, and it's not too sweet, says pro motocrosser Felix Lopez. And Whey Awesome Sauce is really good. And that's coming from Eric Wilson, who is a professional cyclist, a professional motocross and supercross trainer, and a doctor of physical therapy. So it's up to you. Go ahead, check it out. Head over to cellsauce.com/whey. And try your bottle today. Hope you liked this video. Hope this helped you out, get some clarity, and we will see you on the next one. Let's keep digging in and let's keep getting better.